just wave your hands in the air, tell the Lord, thou art welcome, Holy Spirit. We invite your presence, this place. Come and take preeminence. Come, Lord, glorify your name. We surrender. We love you. We thank you. We magnify you. Father, in Jesus' name,
yes, Lord.
We thank you for this wonderful time you have given us to gather here.
Yes, Lord.
At Ezra Prayer Ministries, we have gathered here as a body of Christ. Thank you for your servants who have come here, Lord. And each one of us, my Father, we pray that this gathering is your gathering tonight. May you come and take preeminence by your Holy Spirit. We declare this ground to be a holy ground for your habitation. Come and reign by your mighty power. We worship you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Let's take our seats. Amen. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nikumbie mkono sema haleluya.
Haleluya.
Amen. God bless you. Nawakaribisha tena. Naona kuna watumishi wa Mungu wamefika nyuma. Chairman wetu anaenda chini. Mungu awabariki sana na karibuni sana. Pastor Naomi na Reverend, Mungu awabariki for hosting the meeting tonight. God bless you. And the team that organized this meeting, may God bless you so much. My name is Apostle Kimani. I love the Lord and I'm very passionate about the kingdom. I know I'm in this generation for such a time as this that I may know Him and make Him known. I want us to continue because we have been together. I want us to continue sharing the word of God and also believing God that He's going to visit us tonight. I came together with my wife. Amesema tu angependa kuwave kesho atampatia tutakawanya session yangu na yeye, lakini asimame tu atuwave. Her name is Reverend Naomi. We serve the Lord together. Karibu sana. Usiku wa leo, I want to share with you a message entitled Divine Presence. Divine Presence. And I pray that it will not just going to be a message, but we are going to experience the presence of God tonight in a very, very special way. There are so many things that we can talk about, especially because of the work of the cross. But there is one thing that stands out, and this is that when Jesus died on the cross, the Bible says at that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn into two. Praise the name of the living God. That is Matthew 27 and verse 51. That when Jesus died, the curtain of the temple was torn into two. And the reason the curtain of the temple was torn into two is that we may have access into the Holy of Holies. One as it were sung. That we may have access into the Holy of Holies. So it's very, very important for all of us to understand. We can set aside our denominations, our religion, but one thing stands out, that the will of God, when He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, was to restore us into the Garden of Eden. Not as a physical location, but the Garden of Eden was an environment where there was an open heaven, where God would come in the cool of the day, and He would minister and have fellowship with them. So Jesus came to restore that environment and intimacy between us and God. But we have been stuck in our religion. We have been stuck in so many doctrines. But I believe the most important thing that all of us as believers should be seeking for is to be restored back into the presence of God. That is why when Jesus died, the curtain of the temple was torn into two, because the work of the cross was sending a message to us that from now on, you have access into the Holy of Holies.
Amen.
That is where we had the Ark of the Covenant. And so the will of God in the New Testament is every one of us to experience the presence of God. Maybe somebody would ask me, apóstol, why is the presence of God so important in my life? The presence of God is so important because in the beginning, when you read in the book of Genesis, when before God created anything, he created an environment. An environment, that means before he created the stars, he created the firmament so that he can be able to put the stars there. Before he created the wild animals and the livestock, he created the fruits and the vegetation so that they can be able to eat from that. Before he created the fish, he created the water bodies. Kwa sababu hangeumba samaki, alafu ianze kula nyasi. Bwana asifiwe sana. Akiumba samaki, lazima ingepata, na hangeumba samaki ipate inchi kavu. Akiumba samaki, lazima ingepata maji, kwa sababu lazima ingepata environment. Naye Mungu kabla hajamuumba mwanadamu, he prepared an environment for him. And this is the Garden of Eden. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. The preparation of the Garden of Eden, sio kwamba Mungu alienda pale akajengea Adam nyumba za ghorofa. Hapana. Mungu aliprepare the garden, alitengeneza the spiritual environment. Because already that time, the devil had fallen. Praise the name of the living God. As we see in the book of Revelation, who are to them who live here on earth. Already Shetani alikuwa ameamka. And already there was a covering of darkness that covers all the whole earth. So Mungu alikuja akatengenezea Adam mahali atakaa, na mahali alikuwa akae ukawa na connection na Mungu. Mahali Mungu pia angeshuka, mahali uwepo wa Mungu ulikuwa evident. Praise the name of the living God. Na mwanadamu akaweza kuishi pale akiwa naked, akiwa hajui magonjwa, akiwa hajui depression, akiwa hata hajui kifo, kwa sababu uwepo wa Bwana ulikuwa mahali pale. Lakini wakati mwanadamu alifanya dhambi, akafukuzwa kutoka kwa shamba. It was not just about the garden. He was chased he was chased from the presence of God. Na wakati Adam na Eve waliondoka katika uwepo wa Bwana, ndio tumepata hizi shida zote ambazo tuko nazo, kuanzia kifo, magonjwa, taabu ambazo mwanadamu wako nazo, ni kwa sababu tuliondoka katika uwepo wa Bwana. So when the second Adam came, alikuja kuchukua dhambi zetu, ili kwa kuchukua dhambi zetu tukaweze kurejeshwa mahali tulifukuzwa pale mwanzo. Na ndiposa wakati Yesu alikufa, the curtain of the temple by itself, something that had, you know, in the Old Testament they could not imagine that. Kwa sababu mahali pale hata kuhani mkuu alikuwa anapigiwa kura. Ukipigiwa kura ya kwamba ni wewe unaingia in the Holy of Holies, unaambiwa brother, kibana. Because unaezaenda ukose kurudi. Mtu alikuwa anaingia pale na kamba, nyororo na kengele. Ndio ukiwa pale unatiliza mguu unasema ndio niko tu bado sijakufa. Praise the name of the living God. Kwa sababu mtu angeingia pale ukufe. Na ukikufa kwa sababu kuna siku moja mtu alikufa. Haiko kwa Biblia, ni mimi nafikiria. Ndio waanze kufunga watu na nyororo. Kwani kulikuwa kumefanyika namna gani? Si mtu alikufa siku moja, wakienda kumtoa unakufa. Mwingine akiingia kutoa anakufa. Wakasema hapana. Hapa mahali mtu aingia na nyororo. Ndio ukianguka unavuta wewe. Pastors, mnaona kama mahubiri ingekuwa namna gani siku ya leo, kama ingekuwa ni kupiga kura. Ndio unaingia pale, na kama uko na shida, dhambi na nini, haurudi. Bwana asifiwe sana. Ingekuwa namna gani? Kuna watu wengi wangedecide kuhubiri. Sema kulingana na vile mimi nakaa, sitaki niangaliwe na kura. Because naweza ingia pale nikose kurudi. Praise. Kwa hivyo, that curtain that separated the Holy of Holies, haikuwa mchezo. But when Jesus died, it was torn into two. Ikapasuka. Mungu alikuwa anasema, welcome back into my presence. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. Mungu alikuwa anamkaribisha mwanadamu arudi katika uwepo wake. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. The Bible says at that moment the curtain of the temple was torn into two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So ni kumaanisha kwamba tuweke nini zetu kando na tufikirie namna tunawezaje kurejesha uwepo wa Mungu. Kwa sababu uwepo wa Mungu, in the presence of God, wakati Mungu aliumba every other thing, he created an environment. And the only environment about be conducive for an Adam, it is in his presence. I thank Sister Javi Mentorea some testimonies from Heaven's Gate. And it's a place of prayer. This morning there is a resident pastor. We have two resident pastors in Heaven's Gate. This morning, one of the pastors, he sent me a photo. And he sent me a photo of somebody, and the lady alikuja na crutches. Na alikuwa amepelekwa hospital, shida yake inatafutwa inakosekana. So alikuja pale, mama akasikia kuna mahali watu wanaomba na wanapokea miujiza pale. Sasa wakaenda na msichana. Walienda tu kwa sababu kulikuwa na fellowship za jioni, fellowship za asubuhi na jioni. Baada ya maombi ya jioni, hata hakuepoa na mtu, akasikia miguu imepata nguvu. Na kaanza kutembea. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. What is the most unique thing? Ni kwa sababu katika uwepo wa Bwana, in the presence of God, there is restoration. Praise the name of the living God. In the presence of God, there is activation of your potential. In the presence of God, you are able to function to the fullness of your capacity. In the presence of God, every bacteria will die. Amen. Every virus will die. Amen. In the presence of God, every spirit of infirmity will go in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. Hallelujah. Because in the presence of God, because the presence of God is creative.
Amen.
Well, that's what you know, when we talk about John chapter 1 and verse 4, that when Jesus came, in him was life, and that life was the light of men. The life of God is not the way you are alive. It is called Zoe. Zoe is a God kind of life. It is life as God had it in himself. And the kind of life that God has, we can see it in the book of Numbers, like when there was the chorus rebellion. When there was confusion and God told Moses, choose 12 sticks representing all the tribes of Israel. And Aaron's staff, when it was kept in the presence of God just for one night, it abandoned and it had fruit. And it was a dry stick. The presence of God, the life of God, can give life to that which is dead.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God. We need that life in the church. Amen. We need that life in our families because there are so many things that are dying. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
You may walk. You know, I told people, I think we were in Seattle. I don't remember which state. And we were just driving by the Lord. But everything I could see, it's beautiful. But when we were driving, I felt the smell of death. Because here, roof ya kifo. Kila kitu naona kiko sawa. Lakini I feel the smell of death. Praise the name of the living God. So, tunaweza kuwa pa America na tunaona mambo yote ni mazuri. Lakini kuna harufu ya kifo. Na hicho kifo, kinaweza ondolewa tuna uwepo wa Bwana. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Hicho kifo, kinaweza ondolewa. Ukiona mambo yale yanakuwa rahisi hapa, inakwambia there is, kuna kifo kinaingia. Na hicho kifo kinahitaji tu uwepo wa Bwana. Ndiyo kiu cha madawa kiondoke. Ndiyo magonjwa complicated yaanze kuondoka. Ndiyo addictions, praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah, zianze kuondoka. Ndiyo depression, zianze kuondoka. Kuna itajika uhai wa Bwana. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So I want us to look at a few things about the presence of God so that when we pray together tonight, we are going to trust God that God is going to help us. We are going to read the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 13 and verse 3. And we are going to study this topic through the example of the life of the man of God, David. Because God testified concerning David and he said, David is a man after God's or after my own heart. And the Bible says in 1 Chronicles chapter 13, in verse 3, this is David. Let us bring the ark of our God back to us, for we did not inquire of it during the reign of Saul. Verse 2. The whole assembly agreed to do this, because it seemed light to all the people. Verse 5. So David assembled all the Israelites from Siholiba in Egypt to Lebo Hamath to bring the ark of God from Kiriath Jearim. Praise the name of the living God. David, when he became the king of Israel, he said, there is one thing I want us to do. Although I am at the helm of leadership, I've been fighting battles, I've been living in caves. But David said, my most desirable thing, as much as I am the king, is the presence of God. And he said, because the Ark of the Covenant represented the presence of God. And David said, in the time of Saul, the presence of God or the Ark of the Covenant was neglected. That means all the years when Saul was a king, he did not care about the Ark of the Covenant. It is possible for people to continue with life and business, and even church becomes as business as usual, but the presence of God is not there. But in the time of David, David was different. He was different from religion. He was different because people were haunted. They were worshipping. That time the tabernacle was at a place called Gibeah. And people were worshipping. Though the symbol of the presence of God was not there, they continued. You know, the Bible says, Paul saying, in the last days, there will be perilous times. And one of the things he quotes, he says, because people will have a form of godliness, but they shall deny the power thereof. So one of the dangers we have in these last days is because we'll have a lot of churches. The devil will not stop people to open churches. The devil will not stop people to congregate in churches. But the Bible says it will be perilous times because people will have the form of godliness, but they shall deny the power of God. They shall deny the presence of God. The hunger for the presence of God will not be there. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And that is the biggest challenge. The reason we are not able to turn our world upside down is because as much as we have so many churches and so many believers, the presence of God is not with us.
That's right.
We don't have a hunger for the presence of God. Balance with us. But here we see a man, and it's very good to study the life of David. Because David is one of the men that if God can help me to be like David, I will be very happy. Can you imagine you being the president? Praise the name of the living God. Umefanya kampeni, umepigana vita. Praise the name of the living God. But the minute you become the president, useme, there is one more thing I need. Bwana asifiwe sana. Niko na magari, niko na chopa, niko na nyumba kubwa. I can drive any car, I can live in any house, I can sleep in any hotel, I can eat the kind of food I want, I have all the servants I need around me, but I am not satisfied. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. I am not satisfied. There is one more thing that I need. I need the presence of God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know one of the reasons this nation is dying and Christianity is dying and the church is dying? Because when people have money and they can make ends meet, they can pay their bills, they don't need God anymore.
That's right.
And that is why I'm praying for our nation, because God is blessing Kenya. I remember one time I was driving on the road, and you know nowadays everywhere, I think that is one of the signs of cities. Nakuru is becoming a city. They have added two more cities, Nakuru and Eldoret. So we are going to have five cities in Kenya. Nairobi, Mombasa, Kisumu, and now Nakuru and Eldoret. And I was driving on the road, and there were so many cars. And God spoke to me, and he told me, ona vile nimebariki watu wenu, na hawanipendi. Sasa kama ni Kenya, Mungu anasema hivyo na America. Anasema namna gani? Ona vile nimebariki watu wenu. Because hizi baraka zote, zinatoka kwa Mungu. Ni Mungu amewawezesha. Praise the name of the living God. Lakini Mungu anaona, as much as I am blessing these people, they don't have the passion for me. They don't love me. They don't desire my presence. And that is why God chose David. He said, David, I have seen him. He is a man after my own heart. Praise the name of the living God. He said, Saul. You know, when God chose Saul to be the king, even when he was given the prophetic word by Samuel, aliuliza Samuel, kwa nini kuniambia mambo makubwa namna hii? Wewe hujui mimi ni Benjamin. You don't know where I come from. Don't you know my family background? Why should you tell me such great things that I'm going to become the next king of Israel? So God chose Saul when he was very small in his own eyes. He could not imagine that he could become the king of Israel. But when he became the king, he rejected God. He did not have a desire for God. But he said, I have found a man, and this man is David. He is a man after my own heart. If you read the book of Psalms 132 from verse 1, you can see the heart of David. It is a heart that desires the presence of God. May God give you such a heart in the mighty name of Jesus. That's one that in the Bible says, oh Lord, remember David.
That's right.
And all the hardships that he endured. Verse 2, the Bible says, he swore an oath to the Lord and made a vow to the mighty one of Jacob. Let's see the vow that he made. I will not enter my house or go to my bed. I will allow no sleep to my eyes, no slumber to my eyelids, till I find a place for the Lord, a dwelling for the mighty one of Jacob. What a man! He has become the king. And now he says, I make an oath. Praise the name of the living God. I will not enter into my house.
That's right.
And even when I am out there, I will not give sleep to my eyelids. Why? Because I desire to find a place for the mighty ones of Jacob. What a heart. Praise the name of the living God. It's not easy to find these kind of people. People who are so much blessed. They have everything that you think they need in life, but they still say, one more thing I desire.
Yeah.
I desire the presence of God. I desire more of Him in my life. May God give you such a heart in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. One of the things I've been telling people in Heaven's Gate, Prayer Mountain, because I normally go there to pray, to lead people for prayer, we want to make a helipad there. Because one of the things I believe is that people will be coming there not to seek God. You know, many times people pray because of problems.
That's right.
But I believe God is going to shift our goalposts.
Amen.
That will not be seeking God because of problems.
Right.
Will not be seeking God because of challenges.
Yeah.
Hey!
Yeah.
But we shall be seeking God because I desire more of Him.
Yeah.
I desire Him to be my friend. I desire more of Him.
Right.
Praise the name of the living God. Because David was not having any problems now. The only challenge he went through is because Uzzah died. But Uzzah was dying and he was going through all this hardship because he wanted the Ark of the Covenant to be brought back. Praise the name of the living God. He said, I will not enter into my comfort zone. Hey, shake your neighbor and tell them, come out of your comfort zone. In the mighty name of Jesus, come out of that bed. Come out of that house. Seeking the face of God. Let us have cash in America. In the mighty name of Jesus. You people, you have to come out of your comfort zone.
Amen.
And have a desire for God.
That's
right. Zile kesha mulikuwa mnafanya Kenya na Darama. Zilienda wapi? Praise the name of the living God. Nilienda kesha moja. Kwa na jambi kule kwa America, sijai kuona kesha kama hiyo. Kina mtu wako na mkebe ya kahawa. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, ni baba. What is a guy, you don't know kesha. Hii na kesha shiki walikuja kuoka. Praise the name of the living God. Mtu wataoka saa gapi na hako na mkebe ya kahawa na kufunguka naye. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Haleluya. Wapendwa, tusimalizwe na baraka.
Amen.
Tukimalizwa na baraka, Mungu ataona aibu juu yetu. Atauliza hawa watoto wangu, mbona nimewabariki wamewacha kunitamani? Mbona nimewainua wamenionyesha mgongo? Si nilikuwa ninawabariki wanikaribie? Mbona wakati nimewabariki wameenda bali na mimi? Si wawe na moyo kama wa mtumishi wangu Daudi.
Yes.
Hata wakati nimfanya mfalme, he did not run away from me.
Right.
Praise the name of the living God. David, even when he was blessed by God, he did not show God his back. Because there are many people, when they are in problems, they cry to God. They seek the face of God. Praise the name of the living God. I know most of you, before you came here, you prayed at all. You are telling God, oh Lord, remember mercy. Praise the name of the living God. And God opened a door for you. A door of favor. But when you are blessed and you have everything you need for life, then you tell God, it's like I don't need you anymore. I can do without you. Let me tell you, if you find a proud fish, and this proud fish jumps out of water, praise the name of the living God, tell that proud fish it will die. Sooner or later, it will start gasping for breath. Praise the name of the living God. So don't ask why things are dying. It is because you are jumped out of the environment that can sustain you. And the environment that can sustain you is the presence of God. Once you jump out of the presence of God, you start dying slowly. Praise the name of the living God. You cannot survive. The conducive environment for every human being is the presence of God. The foundations of this great nation of America are foundations of revival, are foundations of godliness. If America jumps out from the presence of God, they will be dead in the nation. Praise the name of the living God. The nation cannot survive. Praise the name of the living God. Even in places like Kenya, you just go and see places where there is a lot of witchcraft. People have rejected God. Praise the name of the living God. They start with an nothing goes on. The reason America is blessed is because of their fathers. The founding fathers of this nation, they feared God. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. I say there are so many wells of revival in this nation that we need to dig them again. Wells of revival, wells of healing, wells of deliverance. Praise the name of the living God. We came here to redeem those wells of revival in the mighty name of Jesus. So that God can visit this land again and the nations of the world can experience divine visitation again in Jesus' name. So David had a different heart. Let me tell you for free, the heart of David was not a heart of religion. He could not be satisfied by going and worshiping the tabernacle at Gibeah and the ark is not there. The symbol of the presence of God is not there. Some of us, we are satisfied with the religion. As long as I can go to the church and sing 2-3 songs and I give my offering and I listen to a sermonette or 15 minutes, I am done. It's like you are going to fill the register in the church and tell God I was there, by the way. Praise the name of the living God. It is not a matter of intimacy with God. It is not a matter of valuing your fellowship with God. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. If it was a matter of intimacy, why do we have services here of 2 hours, 3 hours? We went to a mega church in one of the states here with my wife. They only have a service of 1 hour. Everything is done within the 1 hour. The sermon, the offering, the worship, the prayer is done within 1 hour. And you find hundreds and thousands of people saying, this is a good church. Praise the name of the living God. This is a good church. Why? Because we don't have time to be the presence of God. So the earlier the pastor releases us, the better. But you know, when the church, when the presence of God is not there, even spending time in the house of God becomes a challenge. Praise the name of the living God. I want to show you a number of the hindrances that hinders the presence of God in our lives. Hindrances. What hinders the presence of God? And I want you to mark these hindrances, because if you have one of them, just remove it and God will have his way in your life. Number one hindrance is pride. Pride. God hates pride, and you not manifest when we are walking in pride. One of the reasons many people cannot experience the presence of God, because they are proud. Because one sign of a proud person is when you feel I can do it all without God. I don't need God. That is a sign of arrogance and pride. And you see, the Bible says that God opposes the proud, but He gives grace to the humble. For you to experience the presence of God, you must walk in humility and acknowledging that I surely need the grace of God. The Bible says in 2 Samuel chapter 6, if you can give us 2 Samuel chapter 6 from verse 20. 2 Samuel chapter 6 from verse 20. The Bible says, when David returned home to bless his household, Michal, daughter of Saul, came out to meet him and saying, how the king of the Israel has distinguished himself today, disrobing in the sight of the slave girls of his servants as any vulgar fellow would. David said to Michal, it was before the Lord who chose me rather than your father or anyone from his house when he appointed me ruler over the Lord's people, Israel. I will celebrate before the Lord. Verse 22, I will become even more undignified than this, and I will be humiliated in my own eyes. But by these slave girls you spoke of, I will be held in honor. The last verse, verse 23, and Michal, daughter of Saul, had no children to the day of her death. You know, we bear after our own kind. And because Saul was proud and arrogant, and he had no desire for the presence of God, we see her daughter Michal. The kind of celebration here David is doing, he was celebrating after bringing back the Ark of the Covenant. And David was so happy. Yakwamba ali dance mbele za Bwana mpaka nguo zikaanguka. Michal naye kwa nyumba ya ghorofa anaangalia. Wakati mfalme aliingia kwa nyumba, badala ya mkaribishe, anamwangalia, angalia mfalme hapa. Vile anaimba mbele ya wajakazi mpaka nguo zinaanguka. Praise the name of the living God. Akamdharau, akamdunisha. David alimjibu akamwambia, I will be more undignified. You know, when people are blessed and lifted by God, they want to be people of dignity. The way they were kneeling down, the way they were lying on the floor, the way they were crying a lot of tears, they want to be dignified. But David said, I'll be more undignified. That shows humility. What am I saying, sir? Because Babu Micho, anaangalia nasema, angalia mfalme. Vile anaimba mbele ya wajakazi. So Micho is more interested with the position rather than praising the Lord and humbling before the presence of God. Many times when people are blessed, they are more interested with their position and who they are in the society, the kind of car they drive, the kind of house they live, and they bring that even in the church. Yeah? Unakuja na hiyo kanisani, hata watu wakiabudu, unawaangalia wewe ni manager wa service. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. But you are the same person and I. Ulikuwa unakaa hivi unaangalia mhubiri haujali kama machozi inatoka. Because shida zimekusonga. Mambo yamefika mwisho. But the minute baraka zimeanza kuingia, mambo yameanza kuwa mazuri, you want to be dignified. The brokenness that was in your heart,
that's right,
is not there anymore. You don't have a broken heart. Umeingiwa na ugumu wa moyo. You want to be dignified. Then they say, I will be even humiliated. You know, to be humiliated in the church, ni mtu ambaye analia, hajali, ananyenyekea, anapiga magoti na zarara. He is humiliated because he is doing that before the Lord. Those are the people who encounter the presence of God. But when we are proud, mimi ni nani? My titles, my positions. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Hawajui kwamba album yangu ilihit. Lakini kabla album yako haijahit, ulikuwa unalia kulia. Hata ulikuwa unalia saa zile watu wafai kulia. Praise the name of the living God. Lakini sasa kwa sababu album ilihit, usinirushie mawe. Lakini sometimes huwa najiuliza, waimbaji, mbona mkitoa wimbo moja ina hit, hakuna ingine huwa ina hit? Kwa nini hamwezi kufika mulifinya ile button mulifinya kwanza. Mukatoa wimbo ya maana. Sasa mnakaa 10 years. Bado tunasikiza ile ya zamani tunasema wachana hiyo ya juzi. Imba ile ya zamani. Kwa sababu ile ya zamani ilikuwa na upako, ulikuwa na neema, ulikuwa na uwepo. Lakini wakati ilihita, kiburi kitakuingia. Praise the name of the living God. Ile ndio kwa mapande pole pole. Praise the name of the living God. May God deliver us from the spirit of pride.
Amen.
Even as pastors, even as bishops. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. May God help us to walk in humility. One man of God testified, you know him, I think he is the man of God who have been ministering to the biggest gathering in the world, Bishop Adebo. Currently he is doing an open sanctuary of 4 kilometers by 4 kilometers. I have got the one they have been using that can seat 1 million people. It has become too small. Now he is doing a bigger one. God told him, he was in a place, in a beach. God told him, light your name. That is on the sand. And then after writing his name, he was told, delete your name. You know, it's very easy to delete your name on the sand. It's very easy. He told him, the same way you have easily deleted your name, the day you be proud, the same way I will delete your name. That is why when you see Bishop Adebo, even in big meetings, he prays kneeling. Because he knows the same God who has raised him. Praise the name of the living God. The same way he can be able to bring him down if he is proud. Pride hinders the presence of God in our lives. And pride mainly comes because of who we are, what we have, the things we have acquired. Praise the name of the living God. We are filled, they fill our hearts, and we are puffed up. And then the way we were humbling before the Lord, before we acquired the things that we have, we are not able to humble ourselves again. But God marked David for favor. And he said, I have found a man after my own heart. He was a shepherd boy, but he saw the heart. And he said, this kind of heart will never forsake me, even when I have blessed him.
That's right.
You know, the Bible says in Jeremiah 17, that before God blesses any man, he searches the heart. When God is searching your heart today, what kind of a person are you? Is God able to identify you as a man whom he can raise, as a woman whom he can bless? And even when you are so blessed, you remain humble. Even when you are so blessed, you are still going for the presence of God. Praise the name of the living God. Let me tell you, God deals with our hearts. And he knows our hearts. He knows our hearts. And he saw the heart of David. So pride hinders the presence of God. Number two, almost the same thing, but it's about contentment. Contentment. When people are contented by what they have and who they are, they don't seek for God. The Bible says, John 7:37, they that are thirsty, come and drink. We receive the presence of God because we are thirsty. We are ready to come and drink. Praise the name of the living God. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 3. Let me read that one on the last day. Let me pick up something there in John. John 7. 37. On the last day of the feast. This feast was lasting for a whole week. So people have been eating, they have been celebrating, they have eaten every kind of food and all the drinks. But on that last day, Jesus took and said in a loud voice, if anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. You see, it is the last day and it is the greatest day of the feast. People have been feasting for a whole week, eating and drinking and making merry. But that last day, Jesus said, let him who is thirsty. How can I be thirsty? We are asked for the whole week we have been celebrating. It's not easy to be thirsty. But Jesus was not talking about physical thirst. He was talking about his presence. That means, even when you are full of earthly things, there is a place for God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God. Hata wakati umejawa na mambo, Mungu amekubariki na nyumba, na gari, huduma kubwa, mambo makubwa, title kubwa, kuna nafasi inafaa kubaki ya kwamba bado mimi niko na kiu. I'm still thirsty. Psalm 63 verse 1. Psalm 63 and verse 1. Don't allow contentment to overtake you. Oh God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. Even my body longs for you in a dry and a weary land where there is no water. Do you know you are living in a dry and a weary land where there is no spiritual water? What are you supposed to do? You are supposed to seek God earnestly. And you are supposed to be thirsty for Him. Because if you are thirsty for Him, He will come and feed you. May God fill your heart tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. May God find a place in your heart tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because you are thirsty for Him. In the mighty name of Jesus. Number three. Another hindrance that is hindering the presence of God. By the way, this is a revelation message that God has given me. Because God desires to restore His presence in a very special way. In this end time, God is going to restore His presence. I remember some time back, I went to Missouri. And when I was in the airplane, God spoke to me and He told me, when you go to Missouri for the 3 days, don't talk about anything else. Just speak about my presence. I spoke about the presence for 3 days. People would come and just lie in the altar. The presence of God was so heavy. On Monday, I met with one, a college teacher. And she told me, I thought people are pushed by pastors to fall down. But she told me for the 3 meetings I was sitting at the back, and all the days, I could not withstand the presence of God. I was falling off from my chair every day. I was falling off from my chair every day. And I can tell you, I am so transformed. I feel a lot of joy. I feel a lot of peace now in my life. Praise the name of the living God. God is restoring His presence to them that are thirsty in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive the presence of God tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. May God fill this house with His glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Is there anyone who is thirsty? Come and drink in the name of Jesus. Come and drink, for there is a river that flows, and that river makes glad the city of our God. I ask for the river of God to come and flow in this place. I connect you with the river of God in the mighty name of Jesus. I connect you with the river of the Holy Ghost. Yes, let rivers of breathing waters flow from your belly in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I connect you tonight. I connect you tonight. I connect you tonight. Yeah, I connect you tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, let rivers of breathing waters flow from your belly. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Kelababoshanda baganda. Rekabaganda baboshinebeganda. Be connected tonight. Desire more of Him in your life. Tell God I desire your presence. You are my maker. You are my creator. I cannot do without you. It is in your presence where I can manifest my potential. It is in your presence, Lord, where I can receive your healing. It is in your presence, Lord, where I can function as you created me. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive the presence of God. Let rivers of living waters flow from your belly tonight. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Rekabaganda Maboshi. Rekabaganda Rima Masaya. Rekabaganda Maboshi. Rekabaganda Ramaboshata. Rekabaganda Ramaboshata. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Father, let your presence. I declare this ground to be a holy ground. I pray for the blood of Jesus. I pray for the ministering angels. Yes, Lord, let the ministering angels. Let the ministering angels in this presence. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Yes, in the name of Jesus. We need the presence of God. We need the presence of God. Oh Jesus. I wish you could have more time. In the name of Jesus. Let me tell you. It is us who don't have time for God. God is having all the time for us. But we don't have time for Him. You can say you are too busy. But say David said, I am a king. But I refuse to go to my house. I refuse to go to my bed. Because I have a praise for God in my life. I pray that God will help me to desire His presence. I know God will bless my life. And I thank God for what He has done. But I desire, even when I'm so much blessed, even when I'm so much lifted of God, that I will find time for Him. That I will still desire to walk with His presence. In the mighty name of Jesus. May God take away pride from my life. Every form of pride. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. May God deliver me from every contentment. In the mighty name of Jesus. For there is a phrase in my life. It is only God who can satisfy me. In the name of Jesus. Another hindrance is modern idols. There are so many modern idols that have come to substitute the love of our God. And we should be careful of those modern idols. I'm calling them modern idols because when we talk about an idol, people think of a statue or something else that is touchable. But they are modern idols, like sports. If you see how people worship things like football, how people celebrate, they can fill stadiums, they can watch football screens, they can watch football overnight. They have all the time. People worship a lot of sports, different sports, even here in America. You know, there are sports when they are going on. There are people who cannot sleep. Those are modern idols, like TVs. We thank God for the flat screens, LED TVs, those smart TVs. But if you compare the time you spend on your TV and the time you spend with God, and you find the time you spend on TV is more than the time you spend with God, it is an idol. Because it is a substitute for God. It is a modern idol. There are programs you cannot miss. You are addicted to TV. You must watch TV 2 hours, but you cannot pray for 15 minutes. You can watch TV 2 hours, but you cannot read your Bible for 15 minutes. It is an idol. Our phones. Our smartphones. If you see how much people spend time, I was reading an article of how much time people are spending on WhatsApp. Opening those WhatsApp every day. You can read 100 junk messages every day on WhatsApp. But you cannot read a chapter of the Bible. But you can afford to read 100 junk messages. Praise the name of the living God. You are in so many groups. Then you spend time. Ya kuangalia ile mosheni inaendelea kwa kila group. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
But you don't have time for the word of God. Our jobs. Some of us, our jobs are idols. The praise you have given your job and the praise you have given God. Let me tell you, some of you don't have, even God is squeezing a very small corner. He is just about to fall. He is on his way out. Because already anaambiwa, Mungu hapa hauna space. Amesukumwa.
Because some of you think your job is everything. But let me tell you, you can work and work and work. But finally you hit a dead end where only God can see you. Many people, their jobs have become their own, their idols. How has Kosea Kazi? Masaya Kazi is special. Lakini Masaya Mungu hakuna. Mungu yeye, by the way, Mungu nikipata nafasi tutaonana. Lakini kazi kwanza. Businesses. They have become idols. Wengine, some people are idols in your life. You idolize some people. Some people idolize their husbands. Others idolize their wives. Others idolize their children. Others idolize some friends. You are addicted to some people. Jesus said, whoever wants to follow me, they have to hate their self, their brothers, their sisters, their mother, their father. God was saying, I don't take a second position. So if you have to go for him, God is saying, give me the first position and you see what I can do for you. Other people, their God is their stomach. And it is in the Bible, Philippians 3:19. Their God is their what? Philippians 3:19. What does the Bible say? You can be worshipping the God of your stomach. Their destiny is their destruction. Their God is their stomach. And their glory is in their shape. Their mind is on earthly things. Praise the name of the living God. There are people, it's like they worship food. They idolize food. When it comes to eating, unakuta mtu ikifika masaa ya kukula, vile huwa anajiandaa masaa ya kukula, hata huwa hajiandai wakati wa ibada. Anafika nyumbani, anatoa koti, anatoa tai, anavinokora shati, kama ni shati anaitoa nje ndio tupo isipinywe, mshipi anaweka kando, alafu tawele ya kujipanguza jasho wakati wa kukula, because ile jasho inakuwa inamwagika hapo, itahitaji tawele ya kuitoa. Ukiangalia maandalizi ya chakula na maandalizi ya kutafuta Mungu, ikifika ni wakati wa kuomba, unakuta mtu yule kudozo. Time ya kuwashipa hakuna, time ya kuomba hakuna. Lakini ikifika ni chakula, praise the name of the living God, maandalizi makubwa. Praise the name of the living God. Ask your neighbor, what is your modern idol? Yeah? They are people who idolize their possessions. My car. Kuna watu gari, hata nezarana ndani ya gari. Because they worship the possession they have, material possession. There are people who idolize those things. Let me tell you, I'm talking about these things because they can fill your heart. When you have them, you can feel satisfied, you can feel good, and you feel like you don't need God. Let me mention another few barriers of the presence of God and we finish. Unbelief. We must have faith in Christ. We must believe in the promises of God because the promises of God are yes and amen. Amen. Unbelief hindered the miracles of Jesus in Mark chapter 6 and 5 to verse 6. Their presence, Jesus did not do many miracles because of their unbelief. Praise the name of the living God. Religious spirit. When there is a religious spirit, this is a counterfeit form of godliness. It may look good in the outside, but hollow and empty in the inside. When there is a religious spirit, then it hinders the presence of God. Tunakuwa ibada zetu ni taratibu na mipangilio yetu, tunafuatilia. Sasa sisi Mungu ama Roho Mtakatifu hana nafasi. Another hindrance is not understanding our standing, that we are priests unto God, and we have been given full access into the Holy of Holies. In Christianity, there is no spectator because the curtain of the temple was torn into two. Amen. So the Holy of Holies is not for the high priest. The Holy of Holies is for all of us. Amen. Don't just go looking for someone to pray for you. You have access to the Holy of Holies by the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. That is why so many people in the church today, they are manipulated. Because you think until I get a great man of God to pray for me, my problems will never be solved. But you forget you have access in the Holy of Holies. Amen. you forget or you don't understand your standing. That now the Holy of Holies is not just for the high priest. It's for all of us we can access. There is a place for men of God to exercise divine authority over your life. They are charity, they need to stand with you. But there is a place you can pray like Hannah and enter into the Holy of Holies and ask God. You know, I went to Israel a few months ago together with my wife, and we went to Shiloh. Shiloh is where Hannah was going to pray. That is where Eli was a priest. And in those sites, they have people who explain to you what was happening there. And the lady who was there told us, Israel, even today, they learn from the prayer of Hannah that you can go direct to God. Because that time when they were going to Shiloh, all the sacrifices were offered by the priest. Everyone else was a spectator. But here comes Hannah, and he enters into the house of God, and he goes direct to God, covenanting, interceding before the Lord. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And they learn from the prayer of Hannah, even from the Old Testament, that God is accessible. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. You can access God for yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. You can access God for your miracle in the mighty name of Jesus. May you reach out to God for your miracle tonight. I destroy every religious spirit in our midst in the mighty name of Jesus that can hinder, oh my God, the miracle working power of God to flow in our midst in the mighty name of Jesus. Another hindrance is sacred sin. When we are living in sacred sin, if a man cannot get through to God, it is because there is a sacred sin that he does not intend to give up. Is there something that God has been directing you to address? He desires warm fellowship and his spirit move freely in your life. It is very important for you to address any sacred sin in your life. And it can become a barrier to the presence of God. Other things that can hinder the presence of God is painful past. Some of you have been hurt by people. You have gone through stress. You have gone through depressing issues. And the past that you have gone through can affect you to experience the presence of God even now. Jesus said, I have come to heal the brokenhearted. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs that hope deferred makes the heart sick. That is Proverbs 13 and verse 12. Yakoba kuna jambo litarajia litafanyika katika maisha yako. Na kwa sababu halijafanyika, moyo wako umegonjeka. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Hope deferred makes the heart sick. But a longing fulfilled is the tree of life. Pengine kuna mambo ulitarajia Mungu atafanya katika maisha yako. Na haya kufanyika, yanaweza kufanya moyo wako ukagonjeka. Psalms 147 and verse 3 inatuonyesha kwamba kuna watu huwa na majeraha kule ndani. They are like a broken system. Psalms 147 and verse 3. The Bible says, he heals the brokenhearted and he binds up their wounds. Are you wounded by a situation? Maybe by a broken marriage. Maybe somebody took advantage of you. Praise the name of the living God. And you are wounded in the inside. Those wounds can hinder the presence of God in your life. Praise the name of the living God. Zamani nilikuwa ninaona inzi wakijaa kwa meza. Ninajaribu kuwachapa waondoke. Mama anakuja ananiambia, wacha kuchapa inzi. Chukua kitambaa, panguza uchafu kwa meza. Ninachukua kitambaa, ninapanguza meza. Nikipanguza meza, inzi zinaondoka. Kwa sababu zilikuwa zinavutiwa na uchafu. Kuna mambo yanaweza kukutia, mapepo yanakufinyiria. Huo uzaha unatoka kwa hizo vidonda. Kuna mapepo yanakuja kufurahia. Uwepo wa Bwana hauwezi kushuka. Lazima ukubali hizo vidonda zipone. Wengine tulipitia maisha magumu. Praise the name of the living God. Na hayo maisha magumu yakatuacha na majeraha. Hata kama tumebarikiwa. You know you can have a lot of money but you are still poor. Ile poverty mentality. Ile mentality ya shida haijawahi kukuacha. And that is only mtu akijaribu kuona, akitaka kuona shida, aguze hata dola moja yako. Ndio atajua America kuna 9/11. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Kwa sababu ndani yako haujawahi kujikubali ya kwamba now that God has blessed you, the past is gone. Praise the name of the living God. And I need to come out of my past that I may enjoy the blessing of God in my life. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Some of all, you, even the way you work, it's because you are still not believing that God has blessed you. You are working for so many hours because you are trying to make a statement. Please sit down and celebrate the blessing of God in your life.
Amen.
Don't keep yourself working 18 hours in a day. God has already blessed you.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Don't want to make a statement to anyone. Believe that God has blessed me. Praise the name of the living God. Kila siku iko na shida zake za kuitosha. Wacha upone majeraha yote. When in ministry, you know ministry is challenging. And there are so many challenges and battles in ministry. Maybe you have been wounded in the work of the ministry. Allow God to heal you tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Allow the presence of God to take over in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. So I'm sharing the things that can hinder the presence of God to come upon our life tonight. The sin of immorality. And that is very specific. Because there is something that the Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18 to 20. That our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And when you commit the sin of immorality, you use your body. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 18. This is a big hindrance in the church today. It hinders the presence of God. Free from sexual immorality. All other sins a man commits are outside his body. But he who sins sexually sins against his own body. Verse 19. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. Verse 20. You are bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your body. The sin of immorality, because you are using your body to commit the sin, you defile the temple. And when you defile the temple, the presence of God lives. Praise the name of the living God. Sexual temptations, or temptation toward sexual sin, is everywhere. And to everybody, none of us is special. But if you have a strong desire for the presence of God, you have to say no to sex outside marriage. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Because some of these things, they have come in the church to define us so that we cannot enjoy the presence of God. And you see, sexual sin inaweza kupatia fulfillment only for a short time. But when you are done with it, you feel a lot of emptiness. Unasikia vibaya. You open doors for demons that come and tormenting your life. And you find, you know, sexual sin will also affect other areas of your life. Because when you give the devil a legal ground, if you give the devil a nail in your house, he will hang everything that he desires to hang in your house. Praise the name of the living God. We need God to deliver us in the church from sexual sin. The people who have been standing for many years for God, I remember a testimony of a man of God who had served God faithfully for 40 years. And after 40 years, akaanguka into sexual sin. Ali commit sexual sin na msichana wa 18 years ambaye alikuwa amelelewa kwa Sunday school yake. When they finished, msichana akamwambia, nimekutafuta miaka hii yote 40. Pastor akaangalia msichana akasema, si msichana ako na 18, kwa nini anaongea juu ya miaka 40? Akajua ni pepo inaongea. Alianza tu kulia, akajua kumbe shetani amenifuata miaka 40. Nimekuwa mwaminifu, lakini umenitafuta uniangushe kwa miaka hii yote. Kwa hivyo hata kama umesimama 20, 30 years in salvation, 35 years in salvation, please remember, the devil is not tired. He has not given up. Even when you are in marriage, you say that kwa sababu mimi nimeoa na nimeolewa, shetani hiyo pepo imeniwacha, haitakuacha, itaingia na wewe kwa marriage. Praise the name of the living God. Those temptations itaingia na wewe, atajaribu kukuentice. Praise the name of the living God. Atajaribu kuseduce. And some of these, they are seducing spirits. Zingine ziko ndani ya watu, zingine ziko tu kwa hewa, unasikia tu. Watu wengine usema shetani ni wa 56, anasimama tu hapo, unasikia mambo inakuja kwa mawazo yako. Ikatai. The grace of God teaches us to say no to every form of ungodliness. I will not defile the temple of the Holy Spirit because I desire the presence of God in my life. Bwana asifiwe sana. Anyway, najua kwa America muna hizo shida ziko upande wa Malaysia. I'm just trying to warn you, just in case the problems in Malaysia comes here in America. Praise the name of the living God.
Hallelujah. Si America ni mahali ya wani, si niona kukija ile upepo ilikuwa inakuja, ilikuwa inaitwa Florence, mnakuwa wani mjitayarishe. This is just a warning that in case the enemy comes with temptations of sexual immorality, please stand up for your God. Declare, my body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And when you have fallen into sin, you can go back to the Lord and tell God, I repent. When your repentance is genuine, God will forgive you and He can restore you back, because He is a God of a second chance. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. If the repentance is genuine, He will tell you, my daughter, my son, I've been waiting for you. Come back, He forgives you. Praise the name of the living God. But repentance means also you turn away from that sin and you tell God, I want to follow you in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you ready for the presence of God tonight?
Yes.
I want us to take a few minutes for prayer. And I just want to finish by saying, if there is one thing that can help you to manifest your potential, it is the presence of God.
That's right.
If there is any conducive environment for the seed of God that is in you, it is in the presence of God. Some of you may never know that you carry a very strong and powerful gift. You may never know that you have a lot of potential in your life. You may never know that even what you are doing, you are operating below your potential. But the minute you allow the presence of God, you enter into the presence of God, then you find that you are able to manifest your potential. Praise the name of the living God. You manifest the seed of goodness. Maharagwe huwa inapandwa kwa mchanga. Dio inakua. Mahindi huwa inapandwa kwa mchanga. You are also a seed. The seed of the woman. Wewe utapandwa wapi? Dio ukaweze kukua. Utapandwa katika uwepo wa Bwana. Ninakupanda katika uwepo wa Bwana usiku wa leo. Na unapoingia katika uwepo wa Bwana, may you manifest your potential in the mighty name of Jesus. In the presence of God there is healing. In the presence of God, there is deliverance. In the presence of God, you find rest. Praise the name of the living God. Moses said, what is going to distinguish us and your people? Between us and all the other nations. Do you know the difference between a church gathering and any other gathering? It is the presence of God.
Amen.
The difference between a crusade and a political rally, it's not the instruments. They may even have better instruments. Moses said, what is going to distinguish us? It is not the car. They can even drive better cars. They can even live in better houses. But your distinction mark as a believer is the presence of God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And the presence of God will give you rest.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
I pray for the presence of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, to be the mark of your life, to be the mark of your ministry, to be the mark of your gift. Every time you are ministering, the presence of God, every time you are singing, anybody can have a good voice, and they can be able to sing, but we need the presence of God. I am not a lecturer. I am not a motivational speaker. When I speak, I desire the presence of God to be manifested in the mighty name of Jesus. There is a difference between a man of God, between a preacher and a lecturer, between a preacher and a motivational speaker. A preacher, when they are speaking at the supernatural. Hakuna wakati unasikia lecturer alikuwa anafundisha, motivational speaker anaongea, unasikia tu mtu alikuwa na uvinde umeondoka. Hapana. Lakini when a preacher is preaching,
that's
because
right,
they are connected with the presence of God.
Yeah.
Unasikia, nilikuwa na umwa na kichwa. Nilikuwa na uvimbe umeondoka. Nilikuwa na hii shida imeondoka. I have seen so many times in our meetings, even without praying for people here, you see the people who have been healed, the people who have been set free. There are so many. Praise the name of the living God. There are so many people who have been set free in meetings. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Even in the meetings we have come in from Seattle, we have seen so many healings. Because when the presence of God is allowed to take preeminence, God is going to come and sort out your issues. You can be here and God is restoring back your children to come back home. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I know in Seattle a lady who came and said there is someone who got lost about 2 weeks ago. After prayer, the following week, the boy was found.
Praise the name of the living God. We call back our children to come back home. Our husbands, our wives, our loved ones to come back home. In the mighty name of Jesus, when the presence of God comes down, there is restoration, there is healing, there is deliverance, there is freedom. In the mighty name of Jesus, cancer will die from the root. In the mighty name of Jesus, when the presence of God is there, addictions are broken. In the mighty name of Jesus, when the presence of God is there, depression is lifted. When the presence of God is there, there is breakthrough. Marriages are healed. In the mighty name of Jesus, when the presence of God is there, gifts are manifested. In the mighty name of Jesus, when the presence of God is there, people can manifest their potential. In the mighty name of Jesus, yes! When the presence of God come down, in the mighty name of Jesus, I desire more of you, Lord. More of your presence, my Father. Go now in the mighty name of Jesus. You spirit of religion, you are defeated in the mighty name of Jesus. We are throw away our idols, our modern idols, and we call upon the name of the Lord. And we declare we desire more of His presence. Rise up on your feet wherever you are.
We give you all the glory, Lord. We magnify your holy name, Jehovah.
Holy Lord,
your name, it is the name.
Our desire,
it
is
your
name. Our desire, it is your name. God desires that we walk with the presence of God now. Are you ready for the presence of God? Are you ready for the presence of God? Some of you are going to experience the presence of God even when you are driving. You're going to experience the presence of God in your houses. When you receive Jesus, you are a candidate of the presence of God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Wewe utatembea na uwepo wa Bwana. Mahali popote utakapoenda, wale waliofungwa watafunguliwa. Katika jina la Yesu. Leo ukienda kwa nyumba yako, vifungo vyote lazima viondoke. Mapepo lazima yachoke na moto. May God give you the heart of David, that even when you are blessed, you still have a praise for God. Even when you are blessed, you still desire to have more of Him in your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let me begin this prayer. Just for us for a moment, just go before the Lord and tell God, I know what can separate me with your presence is sin. Just tell God, forgive me every sin. If there is any idol I have changed, if there is any sin, oh Lord, in my life that I have covered, today I come before thee in repentance. In repentance. And if you feel there is an area you need help in area of repentance, just come in front here. Kama unasikia kuna jambo kizuizi kikubwa, just come and I'll help you. I'll lead you in a prayer of repentance. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let us all go before the Lord and ask for forgiveness. But if there is something that you need help, you can come in front here and I'll help you. I'll lead you to the Lord. I'll pray a prayer of dedication in dedicating your life. Let us go before the Lord and tell God, forgive me tonight. Any sin, oh God,
Rika baganda babushata. Any rebellion in my heart, any idol you have seen, any contentment you have seen, forgive me tonight. Forgive me tonight. Forgive me tonight. Grace me with your blood, Lord. Rika baganda babushata. Rika baganda babushata. Rika baganda baburia biatai. Father, forgive us, O God, we pray tonight. Forgive us our sins, we pray. We need your presence, O God. Rekabaganda Ramabushata. This city needs your presence. Rekabaganda Ramashata. Rekabaganda Ramashata Maganda. Rekabaganda Ramashata. The state of Massachusetts needs your presence, O God. Rekabaganda. Let there be an open heaven, Lord. Rekabaganda because of the blood. Rekabaganda Ramashata. Without your presence, there will be dead. Oh, Shaka Ramaganda Rivahata. Rekabaganda Ramashata Maganda. We repent of the wickedness. We repent of the evil altars. Rekabaganda Ramashata. But I've been raised in this land. We ask for your forgiveness. We ask for your forgiveness. We ask for your mercy. Siwendele kumwambia Bwana tusamehe dhambi za kanisa. Dhambi, dhambi za mji wetu. Dhambi za our state. The state of Massachusetts. Unajua maombi yanayofanyika mahali hapa. Just go before the Lord and tell God, I ask for forgiveness. Even in your family. Even in your calling. Even in your ministry. Just stand in the gap and ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for forgiveness. In the mighty name of Jesus. The presence of God is coming down. The presence of God is coming down. The presence of God is coming down.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Let your presence, O God, let your presence, my Father, let your presence, my King, Rekabaganda Rababushata, let rivers of breathing waters, let rivers of breathing waters, rivers of breathing waters, rivers of breathing waters, rivers of breathing waters, flow from our bellies, Rekabaganda Baboshi. Yes, Lord. We need your presence. 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 We are thirsty. We are thirsty. We are thirsty. We are thirsty for you. We are thirsty for your presence. This is a dry land. This is a dry land where there is no water, my Father. Release the living waters. Let the living waters flow now in the mighty name of Jesus. Take over every situation that has troubled the minds of your people. In the mighty name of Jesus. Rekabaganda Rabosheta. Rekabaganda Rababuria. Rekabaganda Rababosheta. Rekabaganda Ribabosaya. Rekabaganda Rababosheta. Wajaze Bwana. Feed your people with your presence now. Shata Rabaganda Riba. Rekabaganda. Holy Spirit, for a fresh, for a fresh, times of refreshing, 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 Lord, times of refreshing from the throne of grace, 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 from the throne of grace. Yes, 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 Lord, yes, my Father. Rekabaganda Rababoshi, Rekabaganda Rababuria, Rekabaganda Rababoshata, Ujazwe Upia, Ujazwe Upia, Ujazwe Tena, Ujazwe na uwepo wa Mungu, unaondoka hapa na uwepo wa Bwana, unaondoka hapa na uwepo wa Bwana, magonjwa lazima yaondoke, mateso lazima yaondoke, vizuizi lazima viondoke, kipawa chako kifunguliwe. Kipawa chako kiweze kufanya kazi. Pokea ufunuo mpya. Pokea neema mpya. Nafungua kipawa chako. Nafungua kipawa chako katika uwepo wa Bwana. Hey, I release your potential. Ila marosha ta ila baganda. Reka baganda mabushi nimeanda. Reka baganda rababuri ya miatai. Reka baganda rababushi. Lord, let your presence, my Father, let your presence, O God, feed your people in the mighty name of Jesus. The blessings of God will feed your life today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. The presence of God will feed your life. Rekabaganda Rababosheta. Rekabaganda Rababosheta. Thank you.
your presence, Lord. Let your presence, Lord, break up Uganda, sanctify us, Lord, by the blood of Jesus. Forgive us every sin, oh God, that can hinder your presence tonight. Forgive us every evil. Forgive us every wickedness. In the mighty name of Jesus, remove every barrier that can hinder your glory.
Yeah.
amekuja kufanyia nguvu zako upya. Pokea hiyo neema. Pokea neema kwa kipawa chako. Pokea neema kwa mwito wako. Ndio. Ndio. Amekuja kufanyia nguvu zako upya. Amekuja ondoa uchovu. Baba Baba Moshata na Maganda. Rika Maganda na Maboshere Megenda. Rika Maganda ni Maboshere Megenda ni Mabozaya. Rika Maganda ni Maboshere Megenda. Oh my God, deliver your people tonight. you, Father. Restore your presence, O God, in Massachusetts. I pray for the body of Christ here, that the church will experience the move of God in a special way, that your servants are going to experience the move of God in a special way, that you are inviting the intercessors, that the intercessors will be able to pray more than ever before, in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy the covering of darkness over Massachusetts, over all the cities, in the mighty name of Jesus. I release the open heaven now, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. All you get, lift up your heads now, that the King of Glory may come in, the King of Glory.
Oh my God.
that you are going to have irresistible hunger for the presence of God. Some of you are going to fast for many days. And let me tell you, fasting is not hard. Jesus said, my disciples will fast when I am gone. That means fasting is a way of attracting the presence of God in you. And let me tell you, the easiest way of fasting is to live a fasted life. Because you don't live to eat, you eat to live. So you can fast by eating small portions, eating vegetables, eating fruits. You don't have to take 3 square meals in a day. You can eat small portions of food just to keep you going. And the more you continue with that, you find that you don't need a lot of food. You can do without a lot of food and you get connected to the heavens. Praise the name of the living God. May God give you the grace to live a fasted life in the name of Jesus. You can do a fast for a whole month, a fasted life. You are just taking small meals to keep you going, to give you the energy you need. But you are still in the presence of God. Even when you are working, you are in the presence of God. I pray for irresistible hunger for the presence of God. Naombea kwamba mtakuwa na njaa. Yes. I know this is a land where people are contented because of where they are and what they have. They feel secure and they feel they have all that they need. But Lord, I refuse this spirit of contentment that is not of you. The Bible says godliness with contentment is a great gain. But Lord, we are supposed to be contented in you, not in our other things. And I pray today that there will be spiritual hunger in this land. People will start seeking your face. I raise the grace of prayer centers in America. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, in the name of Jesus. I raise the grace of prayer centers. They are going to be full of people worshiping and seeking the face of God. I destroy the covering of darkness that have been hidden people to seek your face. And from tonight, every corner of Massachusetts, I raise the hunger, the hunger, the hunger, the hunger of the presence of God. I raise the spirit of prayer. I raise the spirit of worship. Jesus, people will be praying as they drive, people will be praying as they walk, as they do their work, they will be praying, they wake up early and seek your face, in the name of Jesus. I raise the hunger that there will be revival in churches, in the mighty name of Jesus. There will be revival in churches. I pray for hunger in the ministers of the gospel. That they are going to spend time at the feet of the Master, seeking your face, Lord, in the name of Jesus. The same way people create time for their work, they are going to create time for you, time for prayer, time for the word. Yes, in the name of Jesus. I release the grace of fasting in the mighty name of Jesus. Kukusa, hauna uwezo, natangaza njaa na kiu cha uwepo wa Bwana. Baba, naomba uwepo ambao umeachilia utaendelea kuongezeka. Kesho makanisani yote yaliyowakilishwa hapa, utakuwa na mwondoko mpya. Naombea wachungaji upako, naombea neema Bwana, waachilie mwondoko mpya kuanzia siku ya kesho, iwe ni mwanzo mpya Bwana. Massachusetts, my Father, in every city, Jehovah, a new day, a new door, a new beginning, because your presence and the rain of your spirit is coming down. Open the floodgates of heaven and let it rain. Thank you for the healing tonight. In the name of Jesus, I declare everyone who come through the door and they were sick in their body, they are not going out with their sickness. I command every sickness, die from the root. The power of sickness, every spirit of infirmity, you are defeated. Come out of that body.
desire more of you in our lives. We worship you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.